go, guys.
Raquel, so unanimous decision in front of semi-home crowd. How did that feel?
It was awesome. I'm really, really thankful for the opportunity. I had a lot of support, a lot of people that came out. I was going for the knockout, but she's a little awkward, and we kind of clashed a little bit, so it wasn't my cleanest performance, but we got the W, so we'll take it and work on some adjustments to keep our space in. But overall, it was a really great experience. I'm happy to move forward to 2-0, so it's awesome.
What would you say is lacking in the women's division right now today?
I'm sorry?
What would you say is lacking in the women's division?
I think it's lacking a few superstars, a couple rivalries, and some fights that the fans are excited to see.
Do you feel that you might have to take a Ronda Rousey approach where you favor your looks, but when you step into the ring, you can put it down?
I definitely think as a woman, it's important to make sure that we're always beautiful inside and outside of the ring. And I think that it's a part of being a woman. We fight a combat sport, and it's an aggressive sport, but that doesn't mean that I have to be masculine to do it. So I like to play up my beauty. I love pink. I love girly stuff. I'm a woman, and I box. And the world needs to get used to it and get out of the notion to think that women don't belong in the ring. We belong anywhere we want to be. And if I want to box, let me box. Give me my chance. Give me my opportunity, just like the fellas, because we work hard. We train hard. We deserve it. And it's time for the world to kind of wake up. You know, it's 2016. We're fighting, and we're not going to stop.
And who were some of the fighters that influenced you that you could dream and become a world champion?
Of course, Muhammad Ali. I mean, he's such an influential man, such an icon. Somebody that said, you know what, I can, I will, I'm pretty, I'll knock him out, I'll look good doing it. So, of course, you know, Muhammad Ali, Sugar Ray Robinson, Andre Ward, he's from the Bay Area. You know, he's a legend here. We all look up to him. So I have a ton of people that I look up to. You know, Cecilia. Get the last name, I can't really pronounce it correctly.
Breckus,
but she's amazing. You know, she's undefeated. So we have so many people to look forward to and look up to. So I'm just trying to make my mark.
If we can go back and follow up on the Ward Kovalev fight, how do you actually see it play now?
I actually think that Ward is the more technical fighter. I think that Kovalev is very strong and very aggressive, but I think that Andre Ward is a technician, and I think that he's going to break him down in the later rounds, and I think that that's going to be the decision. It's going to go probably the decision, but I think that Ward is going to basically be the cleaner fighter, super technical, sharp, and he's going to get the win.
And last question, what would you say to other young women who are out there influenced by the Kardashians or celebrities of that type, female celebrities?
Like women, do you, be you. You don't have to be fake, and I'm not calling them fake, but it is what it is. Be a woman, be beautiful, do you. You don't have to follow any trends. I set my own trends, I do what I wanna do. I told myself I'm gonna come out to a pink flamboyant outfit, I'm gonna shine, my hair is gonna be cute, and be you, do you. Stop following the trend, because that's not real. That's fake. This is real life we're living in. So be a woman, be strong, but define your own path. Don't look on TV and think that, oh, I'm gonna be a celebrity, I'm gonna be a reality source, I'm gonna put my boobs out of my butt. Do you, be you, but respect yourself. You know, put some respect on your name.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Love yourself, respect yourself. And you don't have to follow no trends. Set your own trends. Just like me.